वेलकम बैक स्टूडेंट्स. नाउ दिस इज अ शॉर्ट नोट ऑन द लर्नर नाउ इन हैंड. इट इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट शॉर्ट नोट बिकॉज इफ यू सी इट इन टू द डिफरेंट हेडिंग्स वी विल सी दैट दिस लर्नर नाउ इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट सोर्स ऑफ सप्लाई टू दैट ऑफ द इंट्रिंसिक मसल्स ऑफ द हैंड. ओके, एक्सेप्ट दोज मसल्स विच are called as the thinner muscles, okay, and the two lumbrical, first two lumbricals, all the intrinsic muscles of the hands are supplied by the ulnar nerve. So it is an important nerve and usually us into the short note. Okay, this completes the short, the introduction part of the ulnar nerve. Let us come to the second point, that is the course and relation of the ulnar nerve. So in course and of relation, okay, the ulnar nerve lies just before it goes into the hand. This ulnar nerve lies onto the flexor retinaculum. So it lies onto the flexor retinaculum. Okay, flexor retinaculum. Okay, along with the ulnar arteries. So it is accompanied by the ulnar artery, rather ulnar vessels. Okay, it is accompanied by the ulnar vessels. It lies between that of the pisiform bone. Okay, on the flexor retinaculum, it lies between the pisiform bone, which is most medially present into the flexor retinaculum, and between the ulnar artery. Okay, so that is the relation in this. While it is lying on to the flexor retinaculum, this divides, the nerve divides, okay, the ulnar nerve divides into two branches. Okay, it divides into two branches, that is the superficial branch of the ulnar nerve and the deep branch of the ulnar nerve, which are also called as the superficial terminal and the deep terminal branch of the ulnar nerve. Let us see this branching and its position onto the flexor retinaculum with the help of this diagram. Now this is the hand, which is of the left side, okay, thumb and the little finger, and this is the flexor retinaculum. I will just draw the flexor retinaculum with the green color, so just to differentiate it. This is the fibrous band drawn in the green color, called as the flexor retinaculum, okay, in front of the carpal bones. And one of the carpal bones, which I told you, is the pisiform bone. So I will just draw it with the black pencil. This is, say, for example, pisiform bone. Here is the hook of the hamate, something here. Okay, now this nerve then, that is the ulnar nerve, it lies onto the most medially onto the flexor retinaculum. This is the trunk of the ulnar nerve, and just on the ulnar nerve, onto the distal side of the portion of the flexor retinaculum, the nerve divides into two divisions: superficial terminal branch here, which is present laterally, and medially it is the deep terminal branch. Okay, this is the deep terminal branch, right? So this is the deep terminal branch and superficial terminal branch. Now this superficial terminal branch, it goes in the palm. This is the palmar aspect. So this will go into the palm. Here it will divide into the two digital branch, palmar digital branches. Okay, so this will go, one of its digital branch will go on to the medial side of the little finger to supply it. Okay, it will supply the medial side of the little finger. Then the second branch will go and will at the web, okay, between that of the ring finger and that of the little finger, will divide into the two digital branches, which will supply the lateral side of the little and medial side of the ring finger. Thus, 1/3 part of the palmar aspect of the hand cutaneous supply is by the superficial terminal branch of the ulnar nerve, and 1.5 fingers are supplied medial half is supplied by that of the ulnar nerve. Okay, let me draw here. So this is a far cutaneous supply of the hand. This is the ring finger. Half of the ring finger on its medial side will be supplied by the ulnar nerve. The little finger on palmar aspect is supplied by the ulnar nerve. And then this is the 1/3 of the palm is also supplied palmar aspect. The skin is supplied by the ulnar nerve. So this is the distribution of the cutaneous branches from superficial division of the ulnar nerve. Hope you have understood the division, superficial division and its distribution. Okay, and it's while this superficial branch is going to give the cutaneous, it also gives a muscular branch. Okay, it also gives a muscular, and this muscular branch goes to the palmaris brevis muscle. It goes to the palmaris brevis muscle, right? So this palmaris brevis is a subcutaneous muscle, very thin, lies on to the surface of the thinner eminence. Okay, thinner eminence. So this goes to the palmaris brevis muscle, right? Let us see the course and distribution relation of the deep terminal branch. Let us see the deep terminal branch. Okay, now if we see the course and distribution of the deep terminal branch, we will see that this will pass between the muscles of the adductor compartment. Okay, muscles of the hypothenar eminence, not adductor, I'm sorry, muscles of the hypothenar eminence. And this deep branch will first lie between the, before it penetrates onto the thinner muscle, as we have seen here. Okay, this is that deep branch, and here are the thinner muscles are there. Okay, this deep branch will then go between the two thinner muscles, and that is abductor digiti minimi. See, this is the abductor digiti minimi. I'm writing in short, you write in full. Okay, abductor digiti minimi, and then it is the flexor digiti minimi. Okay, flexor digiti minimi, so because it is the hypothenar eminence. So these are the three muscles. Other is the opponents. Okay, opponents digiti minimi, right? So this now then passes between flexor digiti minimi. After coming out from the flexor retinaculum distal border, it pierces and lies between abductor digiti minimi and the flexor digiti minimi. This is the cross section of the palm, okay, at the level of the hypothenar where the nerve is crossing. Let me give you an orientation here. Okay, and this orientation means this is the fifth metacarpal, this is the fourth metacarpal, third metacarpal, second metacarpal, and this is the first for the thumb. Okay, the first metacarpal bone is here in cross section, and this is occupied. Metacarpals on dorsal aspect are occupied by the dorsal introsei. So this will be the first dorsal introsei, this is the second dorsal introsei, and this is the third, and this is the fourth dorsal. So there are four dorsal introsei which takes origin from the adjacent sides of the metacarpal sac. Okay, then there are four palmar introsei are also here. This is the first palmar introsei, this is the second palmar introsei, this is the third palmar introsei, and from that of the fifth metacarpal, that is the fourth palmar. So you have understood the palmar introsei. If you are not seeing clearly, just little zoom it, okay? And then see this dorsal and the palmar introsei. From the third metacarpal, taking origin and going laterally, is another muscle, and that is called as adductor pollicis. Write down, adductor pollicis muscle. Now there are these four tendons here in cross section, and these are the tendon of the flexor digitorum profundus, four tendons which will give origin to the lumbricus muscle. So this is the fourth lumbricus, This is the third lumbrical, which are both are bipinnate because they take origin from adjacent side of the profundus tendon, and these are unipinnate, which takes origin from the first and second profundus tendon. Okay, flexor digitorum profund. So these are four lumbricals. Okay, then there are four dorsal introsei and four palmar introsei and adductor pollicis. I have intentionally not drawn the muscle of the thinner amines. Okay, now this nerve, I was telling you the course and relation of the this deep terminal branch. Okay, of this the ulnar nerve. Okay, deep terminal branch that. After passing between abductor, digiti minimi and flexor, then this will now will lie and in relation to the opponents, okay, and to the fifth metatarsal, hooking round the, that is the hook of the hamate, then it will turn towards the lateral side, okay, in the deep to these tendons. This is flexor digitorum profundus is shown, superficialis will be above it, so deep to the tendon, just close to the base of the metacarpals or the shaft of the metacarpals, lying on to the dorsal and palmar introsei, this now will form an arch. If I can show you here in this diagram also. Yes, this is the deep branch. It is going like this, going towards the in the deeper part of this, is going in the concavity of this artery, that is the deep palmar arch. This was the ulnar artery. Okay, as I said, it runs along with ulnar artery onto the flexor retinaculum, and this ulnar artery gives a superficial and deep terminal branch similar to that of the nerve. And this superficial, I mean, say deep terminal branch will go deeper along with the deep branch of the nerve, and then this nerve will lie in the concavity of that of the deep palmar arch, arterial arch. Okay, and this nerve, that is the deep terminal branch of the ulnar nerve, will go right up to the lateral side, where it will end by supplying to that of the adductor pollicis. Adductor pollicis here. So this is the course of the deep branch of the ulnar nerve. Okay, deep. It is quite deep. Deep to the tendons. Okay, deep to the tendons. Okay. Right, let us see the branches. Okay, then I come to the branches. Right, what are the branches? Okay, you have seen the course and its relation. Okay, then these branches are from the superficial trunk, we have already seen. This was giving the cutaneous branches to the medial 1.5, I mean say 1/4 of the palmar aspect and 1.5 finger. This was the cutaneous, and one muscular branch, that is through the palmaris brevis, right? Now we talk of the branches from the deep division. Okay, so it will from the deep division, okay, deep terminal branch, which will give first, we let us take the muscular branches. And I will show you in this diagram, okay, the muscular branches. Now these muscular branches, which are given by these deep terminal branches, they are first given to the hypothenar muscles. And the three hypothenar muscles, they are given here, which are called as the abductor digiti minimi, then flexor digiti minimi, and opponents. So all three muscles of the hypothenar eminence, which are supplied by the deep branch of the ulnar nerve. Then this will give the nerve to that of the medial two lumbricals, okay, that is fourth lumbricals, and to that of third. I am drawing, see if you can see, for just zoom it little. Okay, so medial and lateral, I mean say the two lateral, two medial lumbricals, that is third and fourth, they are supplied by the ulnar nerve. Okay, ulnar, because first and second was supplied by the median nerve. Okay, it was median nerve. Then this nerve also give the branch to all the dorsal introsei. Okay, so I will, and to all the palmar, that means eight introsei, four dorsal and four palmar, they are all supplied by the this deep branch. So four dorsal introsei and the four palmar introsei, they are all supplied by. And then this, just I will show you in one or two. This is the palmar introsei branch, this is dorsal introsei branch, say for example going like this and supplying to all. Just remember that this deep branch, while it is lying into the concavity of the deep palmar arch, arterial arch, it supply, and its termination takes place when it supplies to the adductor pollicis. Adductor pollicis. Now it is said that sometime a branch may also go to the flexor pollicis, and this flexor pollicis minimi, that is the thinner muscle, okay, it may go, but otherwise not, okay, sometime only. So how many muscles are now supplied by fourth was adductor, I forgot to mention, fourth was the adductor pollicis. See this adductor pollicis. So how many muscles? Okay, all the three muscles of the palm, I mean say thinner hypothenar eminence, four dorsal introsei, four palmar introsei, and adductor pollicis, and by superficial branch it was the palmaris brevis. Okay, so these are the supply. Now the second kind of the now supply is for the joints. Okay, so the joints which are supplied is mostly the wrist joint. Okay, the, it gives a branch to that of the wrist joint. Let us come quickly to its applied importance of the ulnar nerve. Okay, and the paralysis, I mean say injury to the this deep branch or to the ulnar nerve ultimately lead to a condition called as the claw hand. See here it is written claw hand. And what is claw hand? Claw hand is there where there will take place the, just I will show you in my own hand, there will take place the hyperextension, okay, hyperextension of the metacarpophalangeal joint. Now then question come, why the hyperextension of metacarpophalangeal joint will, especially in the ring and that of the little finger, it will take place. Now because the reason is that the introsei and this lumbricals, they are paralyzed. And what was the function of introsei and lumbricals, which was going into the extensor expansion muscle, tendon, to the tendon of the extensor digitorum, which was forming the dorsal digital or extensor expansion, and its main function was to the flexion at the metacarpophalangeal joint, and then it was the extension at the interphalangeal joint of lumbricals and introsei. This was the main. Now since this introsei and lumbricals, they are paralyzed because of the ulnar nerve, then reverse will take place. Here will be the extension and hyperextension in the ring and the little finger will be there. And then because this of the hyperextension, where the tendons of the extensors are hyperactive because lumbricals and introsei are paralyzed, okay, this will lead to this claw-like. And why the flexion will take place in the interphalangeal joint? Because here due to the hyperextension, the extension of the digits is not that effective. And because of that, the tendons of long tendons, flexor digitorum superficialis and flexor digitorum profundus, they are become hyperactivity and will produce the flexion at the interphalangeal joint. This is the explanation of the ulnar nerve injury producing the claw hand. This completes the short note on the ulnar nerve. Okay, it is an important short note. Okay, thank you very much for watching this video.